Good morning, and welcome to the House of the Lord as we celebrate our ministry together, especially our ministry with students and our graduates today, as well as our ministry with our after care and after school with Sharon celebrating 10 years this month and this week. So we're celebrating today education ministry and our graduation theme. We also want you to take a look on the back of the bulletin for other opportunities. If you are wanting to give with a mobile app, there's a scanner there. Or if you want to give, there's a bin or station for giving as you leave the sanctuary. The altar flowers today are given to the glory of God and in memory of Bill and Rosine Warnke. And if you'd like to do flowers in honor or memory, we do have a flower calendar in the lobby that you're able to sign up for as well. We're continuing our ministry to reach kids in need with shoes. And so if you have not already purchased some shoes for the kids, note the information to contact Winnie and find out what size and little boy or girl opportunities to share. I continue my Bible study every Wednesday night called The Walk, and this is basic five teachings or five essential practices for Christians. Other opportunities include next week, Father's Day, a special men's chorus, and then on June 27th will be our annual 4th of July celebration and special music. So don't miss those, and take that home with you and put it on your refrigerator to keep you up to date on what we're doing. We're excited to have you and welcome you. Let us stand now together for our opening hymn. Let us affirm our faith using the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Now and ever shall be.
be seated. At this time, I am going to invite our graduates forward. So if you're graduating or have just graduated, please come forward at this time. And I actually have a few little gifts, too. Probably should have put these down here to begin with. Okay. Thank you. Friends, I'm excited today to share with you this graduation celebration. Jamie Lee, will you come up, too, as well? Yeah. We have slides that we're going to share for each person graduating, and some of you graduated last year, and some have graduated this year. And I know we have Renee Haskell, who graduated last year, and she's a daughter of Winnie and Kurt, and it was Lauderdale High, and she's now at the University of South Florida. And so, Renee, we have a little gift for you. Actually, let me give the gifts at the end. How about that? So you want to turn around and see Renee? Yes? Yes. And then we have Eleonora, and Eleonora LaSalle is graduating. She went to South Broward and graduated this year, and she also is going to FAU in the fall. So we're very excited. Yeah. Then we have Emily Hill. Emily was a graduate of University of Florida in 2021, this year, and starting University of Miami Law. So we're very excited. And then we have Gabriella Bowling. Gabriella just graduated from Wake Forest University. She's starting Tulane Law in the fall. So we have two future lawyers in the house. And then we have our beautiful, special, and Jamie Lee Bowles is an Institute of Beauty and Wellness in 2021, and she is here with us as well, so we're very excited. So why don't you turn around, and let's give everyone a celebration. We have other graduates. Yeah, these are our folks who are here today. There are other graduates I want to show up on the screen. Matt, if you continue to face that way, if you don't mind, you can see that screen. Alan Ortez Santiago, he graduated from Palmetto Ridge last year, now at FAU. We also have Colin First, who graduated from Palmetto last year, now at University of Florida. We have Luke Andrew Johnston, a son of Michael and grandson of Marilyn. He was going to Mallard Creek in Charlotte, North Carolina, and heading into the Army. So we celebrate him as well. And then J.C. Minor, who is Lynn Mandeville's grandson, he graduated from Cardinal Gibbons this year, going to FSU in the fall. And Haley Hill, yeah, Haley, who is Emily's sister, graduated last year and now in nursing in Gainesville. So we're very proud of all these folks. And Lexi Wilkerson, UCF last year, and Lexi is now in Alaska, in Denali. And then Micah Almond, my son, UNCW 2020 in creative writing. So we're excited to have all these graduates. Yeah. Oh, Leonie, yes. Leonie, who is the director of our preschool, she received her second master's in science of early childhood studies. So we celebrate her as well. And then Myra Gonzalez, our assistant preschool director, who received her early education degree from FAU in 2020. Yes, wonderful. So these are our graduates, and let me offer a word of prayer for each one. Lord, we are so grateful for each one who has taken that time to learn and to grow and commit themselves to higher learning. We do pray over them for these next steps ahead, whether they're starting college or they're in the midst of it, whether they're starting a master's program, whether they're starting in their career. We just surround them with your love and your grace,
your encouragement, and your help. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Our next celebration is a very important person in the room today, Sharon Swart, who is celebrating her 10-year anniversary as a director of our after-school program. And she began that program. It's one of our strongest ministry and outreach programs to children and families. And we've had, you know, anywhere from 50, 30, back up again. We're just, even during COVID, she was doing full-time learning, online learning, so that every kid had access to a computer and was able to continue their studies. But we're going to start with a beautiful tribute video that Byron, her son, has helped put together. Let's take a look.
So hard, then my feet left the ground. Gravity don't make no sense when you're around. I come up against myself when demons in my head get loud. I don't know how you do it, but you turn them down. I slip and wonder who I'd be. I never found you and you never found me.
Sharon, happy anniversary. I just wanted to say thank you for everything that you've done for me and my family. You are a true inspiration to me and I love you dearly. Bye.
And the rest of your life.
Hi, Sharon. We'd like to extend a warm welcome and greeting to all the people in Fort Lauderdale from Australia. Sharon, my sister-in-law, I'd like to congratulate her on 10 years service with the school. She's done a fantastic job.
Sharon, we are very proud of you and we know just how much the children love you and you love the children. We just want to say from the whole family, from Oz, that we're living in Australia, we're sending much love and we're dearly going to miss you. Stay healthy, safe, God bless always.
Hello, just wanted to take the time out to say happy anniversary to a special lady. my other mother. Congratulations. I love you.
Hello, Sherry. Good morning. This is a surprise for you, and I hope you like it. Here goes. Congratulations on your 10 years prestige, and we wish you all the best. And we love you very much.
Hey, Sharon.
Hi, Miss Sharon. We're saying hello from Nevada. We're at the Nelson Ghost Town. We're so sorry that we're not going to be around for your much-deserved celebration on Sunday, but we just want to tell you that we love you tremendously, we value you, and we wish you the very best and for 10 and 20 more years with our wonderful church.
Your life, I want to have it all with you.
Mercy, Miss Sharon. I loved how you always encouraged me to read and how you made camp fun for both older and younger kids. I also loved how you made the camp a bully-free zone. Happy anniversary.
I want to have it all with you.
Happy anniversary, Miss Sharon. I thank you for all that you've done for me and my family. You've been a tremendous blessing to me, and I'm grateful. And I'll never forget your act of kindness to my family. That's why I call you Mom, and my kids call you Grandma. Love you.
You need to come up now, Sharon. On behalf of the whole church, and for your just gratitude for your many years of service, we have a token of appreciation and love. Thank you so much. God bless you.
I do have a recognition as well. Ben wanted to say a few words about Eleonora because she was part of our music ministry as well.
Morning.
Morning.
So I know how much she loves, where is she? Being embarrassed. There she is. I won't make you come back up here, but I've known Eleonora since I first started coming to this church as a visitor in January of 2019. And not long after I officially was appointed here, Eleanor helped me put together our first children's patriotic event in June of 2019. And then she helped me with the music for Vacation Bible School, and Eleanor helped me with narration for our Easter musical, and she helped us with a Thanksgiving song of praise that we did with our kids. Eleanor was a huge member and participant in our bell choir. Even during COVID, she's always been determined to do her very best and to improve, no matter what it is, and she was always willing to learn. She was a huge part support for me, seeing a younger person participating in our music programs, and I wanted to offer you a music scholarship from our Music and Worship Arts Department, so blessings to you and best luck in your future.
This morning, our scripture readings do focus in on our education and honoring, also tools for life. And so I begin with Psalm 121, verses 7 and 8. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore. And then from 2 Timothy 3, verses 14 through 17. But as for you, Continue in what you have learned and what you have been convinced of, because you know those from whom you learned it, and how from infancy you've known the Holy Scripture, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All Scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching and rebuking, correcting and training in righteousness, so that the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. And then from Philippians 4, verses 8 and 9, finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent and praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. O Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your presence. May my words become your message for each of us, your people. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today is a celebration. We're celebrating graduation, a step, another chapter in our lives. And we pause to recognize both accomplishment and that launching pad into the future. Graduation is not really an end point, but a new beginning, a new chapter. It's a memorable moment in time, a succession from one stage to another. For all of life, we will discover we need tools. We need tools to accomplish tasks, to give us the best chance at being successful and significant. And the Scripture helps us understand this well. The tools that we will need on this journey must be effective and tangible. As we listen to, observe, discover, and embrace each stage of life, we realize three essential tools are needed: our faith, our family, and our friends. The psalmist tells us that God watches over us and desires to keep us from harm, that God watches our coming and going, keeping us in his eye. God promises guidance and deliverance, sustenance, and even joy, a life of joy. In 2 Timothy, he tells us to continue, for Paul was a mentor for Timothy. Continue in what you have learned, and remember who you learned it from. This would be your family. This would be your friends, your nurture, your experience. You see, Scripture and instruction are intended to make us wise, but we need mentors and role models to keep us on the path. Wisdom is even more valuable than knowledge. Yes, in school, we might learn knowledge, but wisdom often comes because of those who have mentored us and encouraged us. We realize our proficiency in a particular field of study cannot instantly make us wise. We have to have tools to navigate life, to build positive relationship. We might find our passion and our place to activate our potential, but there's a bigger part of our life: how we treat others, how we even treat ourselves. That is part of our faith and our family and our friends. Now, Timothy was mentored by Paul. He was like a father to him in the faith, a faith coach, and Paul often encouraged him by writing letters. And he said, be faithful, be bold, be courageous, and trust that God equips you for every good work. Now, John Wesley, the founder of the Methodist movement, started his ministry with college students. The very first window back there, John Wesley, that top window, he's wearing a red cloak. Now, if you know anything about that time period, no one wore red. Unfortunately, I love red. But John Wesley wears red because it represents the Holy Spirit. He is cloaked in the presence and the power of God's Holy Spirit. He also wears a purple shirt, which simply reminds us of God's holiness and that this is really our first bishop in the Methodist Church. John Wesley starts with college students. He's working with students at Oxford University. Do you know anything about Oxford? These are brilliant students. So why is their ministry involved with brilliant students? Because he realized that brilliance in the classroom must be accompanied by making a difference in the community. It's not enough to learn. We must apply our faith to make a difference in the world. One of his famous mottos reminds us, do all the good you can, by all the means you can, in all the ways you can, in all the places you can, at all the times you can, to all the people you can, as long as ever you can. Scripture and tradition remind us that Jesus is the source of abundant life, a life filled with joy and purpose. There is joy in fellowship with God and each other. There is joy in making an impact for good in the world. Mother Teresa once said, "We weren't called to be successful. We were called to be faithful." Success is not the goal. It might be a byproduct of our faithfulness and living a life of significance and service, but it alone is not the goal. It takes intention to not be pulled in a million directions. It takes intention to be informed by what you value. It takes intention to have courage, to say yes to what is most valuable and no to what is causing harm or deviating us from the most excellent path. Wesley's three simple rules were helpful to us as well. Whether we are graduating from high school or college, or whether we're nearing retirement, three simple rules based on Micah 6:8. Do no harm, do good, and stay in love with God and your neighbor by practicing your faith. Philippians 4 put it beautifully. Whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is admirable, whatever is excellent and praiseworthy, think about such things. What you have learned and received, what you have heard and seen, put into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. This is much more than survival. This is thriving in life with purpose. This is much more than passing a course. This is growing in wisdom and in truth. You see, our faith contributes to our own personal vitality. It motivates us. We take to heart that God places a high value upon us as his own beloved children. that God claims us and calls us and gives us purpose, that God offers to us forgiveness and healing, that we might have fortitude. God gives to us kindness, so we might learn to be kind to each other and kind to ourselves. God gives us strength for the tasks that lay before us. There's a beautiful book, very poignant book called The Motivation Manifesto. It's written by a man named Brendan Burchard, and it's been one of the number one New York Times bestsellers. The Motivation Manifesto. And he mentions God. And he says, the small, complaining, undisciplined part of ourselves, the distracted character, wanting nothing but convenience and ease, is unfit to be the ruler of your destiny. You see, apathetic and small-thinking people lay waste to our future. We must awaken now and realize greater vibrancy, joy, and freedom available to each of us. But freedom requires responsibility. Responsibility to choose who we are, what we believe, and how we will leave our print in this world. The legacy that we shall leave. He says the natural foe to life is not some distant death, but a detachment from living now. As we celebrate our graduates, we can ask ourselves as well, what is my next step in my life of significance? Where can I more fully practice my faith, my family, my friendship, in such a way that my legacy is shaping up to reflect God and His love? I remember when my mother passed away, she was 75 years old. It was 2016. And my father said, your mother has graduated with honors. What did he mean? He meant she had lived her life well. It was informed by her faith. She was surrounded by her family. And she was admired and cherished by her friends. We are talking about the ultimate graduation. God's promises are trustworthy. God will watch over your life, your coming and your going, both now and forevermore. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us remember our song of reflection, I Surrender All. Let us turn now to God in prayer. Oh Lord, as we come before you, we are so aware of the gift that we have in the next generation coming up, the gift in graduation, the next steps, the gifts that we have in our family, in our faith, and our friends. We just ask that you give to us continued blessing and guidance, Lord, and we want to claim that to keep us from harm. We do pray, especially for Lynn Mandeville and her family this morning, and keeping her granddaughter in our mind. We also pray, O God, for any who are suffering or struggling. We have some in the hospital. Just lift them up for your care and your love. Lord, we do thank you for the tools for life, things that help us to gain strength and healing and encouragement, especially this day for education and ministry, especially for our aftercare and our after school, and for our leadership in Sharon, for her 10 years with us. We pray also, God, for our preschool and our families and our leadership, Leonie and Myra, for each of our teachers, and for those who dedicate themselves in a life of service, we give you thanks and praise. O Lord, for all our prayers, for all our hunger to learn and grow, to understand and to be wise, guide us Deliver us. Enable us to be your faithful disciples as we pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Let us stand and join in our closing hymn, Love Divine, All Loves Excelling. For the benediction, I do have two things I wanted to share. We had one other graduate at Wake Forest in graduate school, and this is Beth and Barry's daughter, Mackenzie, and I just met them again. They'd been here a few times before, but we're grateful to have you and celebrate her graduation as well. And a big one, a 54th anniversary. David and Louise Crankshaw are celebrating their 54th wedding anniversary. We're very proud of you and grateful for you. Now let us receive God's blessing and benediction. The Lord grant to you the foundation of his everlasting covenant, a covenant of love and forgiveness, that we might have in our faith and in our family and in our friends the great tools we need to navigate this life. Let us go in peace in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
If any of the graduates want to come forward, we can take some pictures up here as well. God bless you.